interesting story.
We could use this for the sheer overlay story.
No, actually we can't because we are using it for TV shoot.
Oh, I can use it.
This is going for TVC also.
I need these two pieces.
I'm so sorry, I can't. I swear.
Starting off, this was the 2017 autumn-winter shoot, the first edition. About this project, it was one of the first elaborate sort of campaigns that we've done from start to finish, and it was done internally by the catalog team, right from conceptualization to final execution.
Just becoming tougher by the minute. We don't have any menswear clothes right now. Womenswear is halfway done. The entire ethnic is pending.
We're really clashing with this timeline. Of course, the main project being the TVC and the TVC stills. So there was a clash of us in terms of merchandise and so on and so forth. So
the only hitch was that while we were doing all of this, and which we hadn't really preempted, was that the TVC shoot also came in.
Coincidentally, the TVC shoot wanted the same number of garments, which were the highlight of our stories as well.
Then there was the ultimate fight, or the war between our brand marketing team and our lovely catalog team, who wanted the same merchandise to shoot, because of course the best of the lot was taken for the TVC shoot.
TVC shoots are going to clash with our shoot, okay, because we need it from the 23rd to the 28th.
It wasn't the question of prioritizing one, it was the question of optimizing both. So there was a bit of a tussle there. I think the catalog team came through very well for us. They accommodated, they went to the other extreme because they helped us put together the TVC shoots before they did their own shoot.
I think that was really easy to work around with, because we did this internally.
Hi, I'm Sonia. I am a fashion editor with the catalog team at Ajio. I was a part of the Autumn Winter 17 campaign at Ajio. I handled the entire women's wear, ethnic and western. It was a very big learning experience, because you get to learn a lot of things from a lot of... So the first thing we're supposed to do is there are multiple plannings happening at the same time. First bit was to interact with the B&M team and to make sure that, the garments are ready and how long will it take, and sit with them and discuss the entire process as to how we will go ahead with this. On the other level, then we had a planning with Hasnain, where we had to discuss the models, the dates, the production house, who will be giving this to, whether we're doing it indoor, outdoor.
Like in terms of the hair would be kind of flying.
For this story or?
No, throughout the shoot.
We had to look out for the models which could create a totally new image in the market for our new look of the website for autumn winter 2017-18.
We like to discover new faces and stuff, so that's what we did with this campaign. Went completely and absolutely Indian in terms of our model selection.
And another planning at the same time was happening with Anu. So there were multiple lines of planning that was happening, and all this had to be happening at the same time.
We began shooting with Indie. Indie is basically that segment of our website where we have clothes from designers that make absolutely authentic clothing, which is handcrafted and handmade and handwoven, and a lot of these natural dyes and all of that.
Hi, I'm Neha, and I was shooting Indie for the campaign Autumn Winter 2017. For the indoor, we had gotten different sets and backdrop ready for Indie. We had selected the colors based on the color scheme of the stories. We had used different styles of sari draping for the Indie. And to modernize the collection more, we had used a short hair model this time.
We saw our Western women's wear line, it was really inspiring, so we all fell in love with it. I think the colors, the prints, everything sort of really inspired us to in fact capture the sort of colors that we went with finally. And if you actually see the shoot, it's got these lovely deep backgrounds of greens and emeralds and maroons and burgundies, etc.
Hi, I'm Sakina. I was a part of the autumn winter campaign. I was actually styling the menswear.
We planned our menswear a lot in advance, even more than women's wear, because the showback for menswear happened a lot before women's wear, and we were able to see what clothes they had, and we were able to book the clothes that we needed for the shoot. Menswear indoor shoot, I think it went fantastically well. We got really, really beautiful pictures. The stylist did a phenomenal job in putting things together and putting the looks together as well. And even the business team, which Kanika was leading, and in terms of creatives, was led by Anuradha. We had a very good synchronization in terms of who has to do what and what is expected out of each other.
Now, outdoor is not your nice plain land or easy land or whatever easy location, you know. It was a difficult task. It was more like a trekking, more like a hike, because this was like a mountain rocky region and we had to make models wear 5-inch heels and walk on the small big rocks. I was all the time afraid that, you know, where this model probably slips and falls and then it's going to be more chaotic. Since we started shooting early in the morning at 5, then becomes extremely sunny, extremely harsh. Again, it even started drizzling towards the evening.
So our brief to the production agency, you know, led by Bobina and team was simple. So it was, you know, find us a space with a lot of sky, a space that is versatile, because we didn't want to travel from one location to the other to shoot, you know, different categories of garments. And of course, something that resonated with, you know, the autumn-winter theme.
I remember when we were trying to make these Indi saris and it wouldn't just happen. The saris would just keep flying and flying and flying, and we're draping the saris and pinning them from every end possible. Not happening at all. That shoot, although it went pretty smoothly other than the draping, but you know, a lot of styling had to be changed, a lot of drapings that we had in mind didn't work out because of the location we were in. The wind was crazy. The smoothest was the menswear shoot in terms of shooting. As opposed to planning for menswear, shooting extremely, extremely well. I think it was because the guys were easy, they were okay with climbing up the rocks that we were in.
Absolutely fun, like amazing fun. We laughed, we had like loud music, lots of amazing food. The production house took care of us really well. And models were a complete fun to be with.
So right from the team of photographers, stylists, hair and makeup artists, art directors, and in fact even the image editors, who really upped the quotient of every single image that they touched. I think what we ultimately created was, you know, a bunch of images that were really beautiful, current, clean, and of course bang on trend. I think overall, with all the last minute changes in schedules and merchandise shifts as well, I'm extremely, extremely proud of what the team was able to create, you know, and the way they conceptualized and executed it. I think it turned out really, really well. And honestly, I wouldn't have assumed anything less of the team.